Assalamu alaikum friends, welcome to this MATLAB Simulink tutorial. In this tutorial I am going to teach you how to design line fault model to analyze the voltage sag and voltage swell scenarios in MATLAB Simulink software. Friends, power quality is an important branch of power system engineering. It plays an important role to ensure the quality of power being delivered to the industry customer. The emergence of smart grids further distinguishes the importance of power quality. A single power quality event, such as voltage sag caused by a fault in transmission or distribution level, may cost the affected industries up to millions of monetary losses. Power quality disturbances are categorized into various types, such as voltage sag, voltage swell, transient, harmonic, voltage notch, and flicker. Power quality research is the study of various phenomena that cause power quality disturbance to occur and the development of mitigation strategy. According to IEEE standard 1159, a voltage sag is a decrease in RMS voltage or current between 0.1 and 0.9 per unit at the power frequency for durations of 0.5 cycle to 1 minute. Whereas a voltage swell is an increase in RMS voltage or current between 1.1 per unit and 1.8 per unit at the power frequency durations from 0.5 to 1 minute. Let's discuss its designing in MATLAB Simulink software. For this purpose, just come to MATLAB screen. You can see it shows the line fault Simulink model to analyze the voltage sag and voltage swell. Friends, before proceeding further, I want to highlight that this model is originally developed by Professor Rodney Tain. This is the reference from where this model can be downloaded. Today I will teach you how to simulate the voltage sag and voltage swell cases using single fault as well as multi-stage faults. Let's discuss the first method and how to simulate the voltage sag and voltage swell case using single stage line fault model in MATLAB Simulink software. It may be noted that this model contains the three-phase voltage source block as shown here. Double click on it to see its values. In the parameter section, first data consists of phase to phase voltage, phase angle, and frequency. As we are using the distribution system, in distribution system, common sending end line voltage is 11 kV. Therefore, in this model, 11 kV is used. Angle and frequency used here are 0 degree and 50 Hz respectively. In the impedance parameter section, base MVA is chosen as 30 MVA. Furthermore, base voltage is chosen same as that of the original voltage, which is 11 kV. The last parameter is X upon R ratio, whose value is chosen as 7. This is the default value. Now come to second block of the model, which consists of three-phase measurement block. It is assigned with the name 11 kV bus. Double click on it to see its values. You can see here we are going to measure the phase voltage. Therefore, phase to ground is selected. You may change it if you want or keep this setting as it is. It may be further noted that same three-phase measurement block is also used here with the assigned name of 0.4 kV bus at the receiving end side. This block also has the same settings. Two scopes are used in this model. This scope is used to measure the instantaneous voltage at the sending end as well as receiving end side of the power system. Whereas this scope is used to measure the RMS voltage at the sending end and receiving end side of the power system. Due to this, two RMS blocks are connected here at the sending end as well as receiving end to convert the instantaneous voltage into RMS voltage. Now come to another block of the model, which consists of a step down transformer to step down the 11 kV voltage into 400 volt. Double click on this block to see its parameters. It may be noted that in this transformer, primary and secondary windings of transformer consist of delta and star respectively. Now click on the parameter section. It may be noted that per unit measurement mode is selected. The second line shows the normal power and rated frequency of the transformer. In this case, rated power and frequency of transformer are chosen as 1 MVA and 50 Hz respectively. The line voltage, resistance and inductance for primary winding of step down transformer are selected as 11 kV, 0.002 per unit and 0.08 per unit respectively. Whereas the line voltage, resistance and inductance for secondary winding of step down transformer are selected as 0.4 kV, 0.002 per unit and 0.08 per unit respectively. The magnetizing resistance and inductance value of 500 is selected for this transformer as shown here. Now come to another block of the model which consists of 3-phase parallel load block. You can see the voltage used here is same 400 volt as that of transformer secondary voltage. Furthermore, the rating of this 3-phase load consists of 10 kilowatt resistive load and 100 volt ampere reactive inductive load. Now come to another block of the model in which a 3-phase fault block is connected here to apply line fault in the model. As we know that in case of line fault, the voltage magnitude is decreased. Therefore, voltage sag scenario can be simulated by applying this double line to ground fault between phase A and phase B. Double click on this block to see its values. It may be noted that initial status is set to 0. It means that initially fault is not applied. Furthermore, to apply double line to ground fault, phase A, phase B and ground options are selected. Switching time is set from 0.1 seconds to 0.168 seconds, which means that line fault will be applied at 0.1 second and will be removed at 0.168 seconds. The fault resistance and ground resistance are inserted here as 8 ohm and 0.01 ohm respectively. Friends, at this stage we have fully discussed about every block of the model. Now let's run the simulation by clicking on this play button. Now double click on this scope to check the instantaneous voltage graph both at sending end side and receiving end side of the power system. You can see when double line to ground fault is applied at phase A and phase B, the voltage of both phase A and B is decreased, resulting in the production of voltage sag in the system. On the other hand, the voltage of phase C is increased, resulting in voltage swell as shown here. Now double click on this scope to check the RMS voltage graph both at sending end side and receiving end side. You can see voltage sag is occurred in phase A and phase B voltage due to line fault, whereas voltage swell is occurred in phase C at the receiving end side. Let's discuss the second method on how to simulate the multi-stage voltage sag case using multi-stage line fault model in MATLAB Simulink software. For this purpose, copy this 3-phase fault breaker block and paste it here. Right click on this block, click on rotate and flip, then click on flip block, then click on left right option. Now connect this block with this 3-phase fault breaker to create multi-stage fault. Double click on this block, change the switching time from 0.168 seconds to 0.3 seconds. Similarly, change the fault resistance from 8 to 0.1 here in order to create different fault impedances in the same model. Similarly, double click on this 3-phase breaker block and change the fault resistance from 8 to 1 ohm. This means that from 0.1 to 0.168 seconds, the fault resistance is 1 ohm, whereas from 0.168 seconds to 0.3 seconds, the fault resistance is 0.1 ohm. By doing this strategy, multi-stage fault with different fault resistance scenario can be simulated, which will result in multi-stage voltage sag in the system. Now run the simulation by clicking on this play button. Double click on this scope to check the instantaneous voltage graph both at sending end side and receiving end side. Whereas double click on this scope to check the RMS voltage graph both at sending end side and receiving end side. You can see when multi-stage line fault is applied, the change of fault impedance during a fault create a multi-stage voltage sag power quality disturbance as shown here. Similarly, you can try to check the voltage sag and voltage swells by applying different types of fault, such as single line to ground fault at different phases, line to line fault at different phases, double line to ground fault at different phases, or three phase fault with different fault resistances. Friends, for your convenience, I have uploaded the PDF as well as this voltage sag and voltage swell simulink model in the form of link in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. That's all for today's tutorial. If you liked it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.